just quick reference, because I put something up about ZXI. In fourth grade, Shauna Hildebrand in Cold Spring Harbor Public School, elementary school, like 1980s. She was related to somebody in facially disfigured territory like herself. It turns out she said, well, you can't really pronounce his name. I'll write it down for you. So she did. It was an XI. And I go, I don't know how to pronounce that. She goes, right, well, it doesn't matter. And she says, you know, he's going to be really somebody special in the future. And I was like, okay. She's like, well, I'm related to him. Okay. And she's, you know, because what happened is, a few days before, a envelope came to the door, and I was put in charge as the Illuminati princess, or royalty, or I don't remember the exact words on it, but it was the Illuminati. It was an Illuminati contract that the whole class and Miss Harrison from fourth grade knew about, because I read it. I had to read the contract out loud. Then we did surveys. I asked them to try to help me solve whatever. And then after they posed their ideas to me, I thought about it. And then I said, well, how about if you take that, but then like you just change it just a little bit like this. I was like, I just think that that might be a better idea. And then I said, does that make sense to you? If they said, yes, great. If not, then I try to explain why I suggested what I suggested, as like you have like half an idea, but if you just tweak it just a little bit more, it actually, in actuality, will like fit like a puzzle piece just so much better. You know, and I mean, again, that's just the way I explain things. And not like talking down to people. I would never, unless they're, for some reason, if they attack me. I have done that before with Shauna. When she, or actually I think it was Molly Finkel, she came at me, her and Shauna, at two at once. And I'm like, I was watching you. I couldn't really, one ear out the other, the volume of whatever you just did. I was like, I mean, I recorded it because I'm here, but if you could repeat that one more time and, like, just try to act somewhat like the rest of the humans in the class, maybe I could help you a little bit better and I could understand you, because I didn't hear anything but crazy when you just did that. And I was like, go. And so then they were, like, totally, like, annoyed that I wasn't, like, getting angry at them back. And so, I mean, this is fourth grade. But this is just the way I am. Like, I mean, like, I don't know. What do you have to yell for? I mean, I know I yell sometimes, but I'm so frustrated. And I've been 41 years just sitting here while nobody, like, I mean, I know that there's some people in uniforms. I see your photos on the extraterrestrial. And people are like, well, I don't know. How do I know if that's what extraterrestrials are? I haven't met one. Yeah, got that. Okay, well, I am one. I haven't met anybody in a uniform. I don't know. I mean, they say they exist. I don't know if they exist. Like, is there actual, like, intelligent life on the planet? I don't know. I haven't met many. I've met few. Tony Robbins was one of them. I mean, there's not many that I would mention. Oh, Steve Morris. He's another one that I love. He's a Canadian. He is the head of Exit Realty. You know, I mean, there's so few that I actually admire. What I really liked about Steve is he wore a three-piece suit. I thought he was very dapper and, like, classy. I always like to listen to him speak because he always seems, like, so intelligent to me. When normally, like, in day-to-day life, you don't encounter people like that at all. So there's that, right? So I put something up about, they said Z wants to, he's going to take over leadership of the New World Order. So I wrote back very clearly. I said, over my goddess, my Illuminati goddess, Nicole Body, will Z ever, like, survive? I said, he's a clear and present danger. He was a threat in the 1980s. I advised and wrote about it. Other people were reporting it on my behalf. I don't know how, at my behest, he actually got into some form of leadership over there. I don't know why you pretend like you have such great relations with them. Shauna who's a treasonous cunt from America, is still alive and doing well. So's her parents, by the way. I ran into her mother and father. They said she's doing well. I'm like, oh, isn't that a church, no less? St. John's Church Episcopal in Cold Spring Harbor. I'm like, oh, isn't that great? Yeah, oh, great to see you. What the fuck are they doing alive? Like, I mean, seriously, America. We've got treason on our shores you're not fucking taking care of. Shauna's not important. Her mom's not important. Z's not important. Trade with China is really fucking dangerous because you're just egging on the fucking egghead game show contestants of the facially disfigured and giving them more credence and credit for shit that should have been shut down like eons ago. I mean, anybody can take fucking responsibility? I also sent the same, I made mention to somebody as my God witness with a picture of President Trump saying that I let him know. I put it on my front page of my two side pages and like my one individual, my 505 IET and my head of the CIA, SSIA. So I posted that. I posted the Z and whatever. And then I posted something about Clinton. Just so you know, part of Shauna's family of Z and South Korea, North Korea, whatever, anything facially disfigured before I got here, they're in their incessant need to, like, control things, lie about things, and then lock up and jam up people because they confuse everybody. With the Lady London being Elizabeth and her seven dwarfs of idiots. While Ruddy and I have our ISIS homited, like, equals, because that's my level of royalty. I get treated in America just as royal as the ISIS crew in wherever they run out of, in arid climates, while Elizabeth's sitting in Buckingham Palace, treated like a queen, while she's not bloodline of Christ and she's not star-worthy. Nor is she related to me. So, go figure out how that works. When, when Ruddy and I went for, 1990, I want to say before 1998, that was like our reunion, which I didn't even know was going to happen. Glad that it did though. Same way, I suppose. But in 19, I think it was either 92, 93, 94, when we went, maybe 93, 94, when we went to arid climate desert, however we travel, in non-importance, but when we were there designing the black and white flag and talking about our plea to everybody that, I mean, I grew up and I was living like the house that we were in, which was just like a normal, like two-story, well, theirs was more of like a desert adobe made of like clay because they were in arid climate, but like mine was, I mean, the one I was born in is brick, three-story, but it's not three livable stories because they have to rent it out to make money to pay for the taxes and stuff. And then the one that I moved to in Cold Spring Harbor was like a two-story, about like the same size, like, that's how I was living. So, and then we went out on a back, like, open, we call it a sunroom, and then they had, like, the canopy that comes down, like, a shade, right, I mean, and then there was a couch over here that Ruddy and I were sitting on, and then there was and then there was, like, a slider. It was like a sandy color, like a sandy tan color, like you see at the beach. But not like the black beaches in Hawaii, you know, not the tar beaches. It's the regular, like, Giza sandy beaches, like the sand color. Right, so that's that. What else am I missing? Oh, right, and that's where Alexander James is my Ali. I call him Alligator, but he's my Alibaba, which is my, right, name for that moment in time, since it's Ruddy and my son, however, we're able to do that in the extra spatial and extra special planning ahead of time, just should all go wrong. The one kid comes out looking exactly like he should humans fail us completely, and not the people in that meeting with the flag, the other ones around the world that I can't rely on, even in my own home country, apparently. Let's see. And that was well after, because I was in my teenage years. That was well after high school, which at that point, when I was in that meeting, I couldn't even remember. I couldn't remember being like a kid and having the eye facial event.
where I was used as like the human antenna and monitoring system, which was Z turning on some kind of Indo-Asian illegal whatever they were doing to monitor me to make sure that I was conducting myself in a ladylike behavior for the fucking queen cunt elsewhere, or so they said, and the seven dwarfs of assholes and idiots that go along with anything that the fucking pointed cunt like says while she's sitting high on the fucking hog as non-royalty. Right, so I mean, like, nobody gives a shit when she fucking dies, all of her family, for causing this. I shouldn't be living like a fucking dirt farmer slave while you're all fucking sitting there and there are people who need me elsewhere. I mean, how fucking selfish cunts like can you be? Seriously. Sean is the same, by the way. She lives, like, way better than I did. I mean, I had to raise Alexander in a small ranch and barely make enough money to feed him. The lights and the heat turned off several times during the winter because it was so expensive and I didn't have enough money. And his father that I kicked out of the house, he didn't have the money. And if I asked for it, he wouldn't give it to me. So, I mean, I went and had to go to court in order to get the money that he actually owed me, like $14,000 in back child support, because he just didn't feel like he needed to pay anything. Meanwhile, I can't keep the heat on and feed the kids. I mean, it's like the sickest fucking human, whatever the fuck you. I mean, I know that, like, my flag people that, like, I was there for, they get it. I don't know what the fuck the rest of the world thinks. I mean, I don't know where the fuck you all live, but I mean, I live in, like, ghetto conditions compared to, like, you in Buckingham and places that should not be breathing for treating me this way and leaving me this long with this many fucking problems and after all you take from me too.